Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah Ashhadu an la Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah Hayya 'ala salaam Hayya 'ala Hayya 'ala al-falah Hayya 'ala al-falah Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
اللہ تعالی
فرماتا ہے that Allah Almighty says in the Holy Quran والذین آمنوا اشد حبا للہ
اور جو لوگ مومن ہیں
those people who are believers
وہ سب سے زیادہ
they are the strongest in their love in Allah Almighty they are more intensely loving Allah Almighty
ye Allah taala ki mohabbat hi hai
this is the love of Allah Almighty
darja by darja
which stage by stage
Allah taala ke pyaron se pyar
which also takes a person to loving those people who are beloved of Allah and such people
mohabbat ke liye koshish
karte hain and such people always strive to get the love of Allah Almighty to get the love of Allah Almighty and they are always very keen and desirous that they should how they are able to please that beloved one in one hadith it is mentioned that the day when Allah Almighty when apart from the shade of mercy of Allah Almighty there will be no other shade available to anyone on that day on that day the people who will be taken under the shade of mercy of Allah Almighty among them there will be two such people those two people who love one another purely for the sake of Allah Almighty this love for Allah for the sake of Allah is for this reason that that one can express one's intense love with Allah Almighty so when an ordinary believer when they have love with one another for the sake of Allah Almighty and because of that Allah Almighty he blesses them in this way so then those who are sent by Allah Almighty and those who are the prophets then love with them how Allah Almighty is going to bless those people this is something which is beyond imagine one cannot imagine about that these are great examples and manifestations of devotion and love and the last end of that is the person of Allah the Almighty and how fortunate are those people who those who show the examples of their devotion and love in order to show that they get the time of the people who are the prophets and the chosen people and the people sent by Allah Almighty and in order to show these examples this opportunity among us there are some people whose forefathers had this opportunity those who found the time of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam and their love and devotion and dedication and respect they showed the expression of that directly to the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam and then also they also became the recipient of the love and affection and kindness of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam today I would like to mention about the narration of some of these saintly people and their incidents and examples I am going to relate and how blessed were those people who touched the blessed hands of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam and directly got all the blessings from him the some narrations which I have picked up today The first narration is Hazrat Walidat Khan Sahib is from رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ. It is narrated by him, who was from Rajput, son of Malik Khan Sahib, in Tahsil Narowal. He says that in December 1907, at the time of Jalsa Salana, I did my bath on the blessed hand of the Promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. And one day before the day of Jalsa, I arrived there in Qadian. From the house of the Promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam, when Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam had to come out of his house, then I saw that there are a lot of people have gathered outside Masjid Mubarak, and as I was a newcomer, so I stood in the another alley, and I was praying that if Allah Almighty may make it this way, that if Huzur comes from this lane, then I will be able to have shake hand with the Promised Messiah. And then I suddenly saw that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, along with the Hazrat Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad Sahib, he was coming from that very way. And he says that suddenly I felt as if the sun is coming out of the clouds and it is all bright. I went running and I shook hand with the Promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. He went out from the way of the Arya Bazaar, and I remember that Nawab Muhammad Ali Khan Sahib, the north corner of his house, from there that Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam returned back. Perhaps Masjid Noor or Madrasa Ahmadiyya, it was the western part of that where the Promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam sat along with the companions, and Mir Hamad Shah Sahib of Sialkot, he read out some of his poems which he had composed. And then Hazrat Madad Khan Sahib, Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anho, Inspector Baitul Mal Qadian, who was Raja Fateh Khan Sahib's his son, and he was from the valley of Kashmir. In 1896 he did bath, and in 1904, and then he saw the Promised Messiah in that year, in 1904. He says that once in my hometown, in the month of Ramadan, this desire came into my heart that today I should observe fast in Qadian and offer the Eid there, and then I should go back and join my job. I had just joined the army recently, and nowadays junior commissioned officer, that officer office I had, and this was my desire that at my job, before that I should go to Qadian so that I can have the look of the face of the Promised Messiah and have the honor of initiating at his hand again. And because the previous path was in 1996 or 1995, which was done by the post. And in those days, it was my first opportunity to come to Qadian. And when this overwhelming desire came into my heart, then I felt that I must see the Promised Messiah, because if I go and join my job, then I may not be able to see him again. Therefore, I decided that first I should go to Qadian and I should see him, meet him, and after that I will come and join my job. So he says that with this idea I came to Qadian. When I saw his face, blessed face, then suddenly this idea came into my mind that if I get the whole valley of Kashmir, still I would not like to go out of Qadian leaving all these things behind. This was the attraction which was compelling me not to go back. And after looking at his blessed face, going out of Qadian became very, very difficult, and so much so that I forgot everything when I looked at his face. Only one idea was there, that if outside your income is 1,000, still what difference it will make? But if you go out of Qadian, then you won't be able to see this blessed illuminated face again. So on that thought, I decided to abandon my hometown, my place of residence, and I decided I will not go there, and I decided that if my death comes today or tomorrow, then Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam is going to lead your namaz-e-janaza, and you will be, you will get everything. And then I decided to stay in Qadian permanently. And this became my daily routine, that I used to write a letter. I used to send one letter to the promised Messiah for the prayer. And I had this fear that Huzoor may not get offended from this a practice of mine, and he may think that he is causing me some trouble. And one day Huzoor gave the reply to me that you have adopted this good way, that you are always remembering me and you are reminding me about the prayer. And I am always praying to Allah Almighty for you, and I will continue doing so. Allah Almighty give you success in the world and in the religious matters, worldly matters. And Allah Almighty will also arrange your marriage. You continue reminding me. And I am very happy about you. And he says that this writing of the promised Messiah, I showed it to another person, and he said that, what is this thing that I have not mentioned about my marriage in any of my letters, but how is it there that Sheikh Sahib laughed and he said that now you are going to get married very quickly, because whatever he has said, it is not going away like that. So you should get ready for marriage. And Allah Almighty is witness, he says, that only 2 months after this statement of the promised Messiah, I got married. Before that, I did not marry anywhere else. And 2 marriages, both were arranged by Huzoor. Otherwise, who was there to care for me? So this was the special attention and the special favor of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, that I got married because of his twin. And what a lucky person I was. Another companion says, who was a resident of Kamal Dera Singh, he says that I bear witness in the name of Allah, there is no one worthy of worship except him. And after invoking blessing upon the Holy Prophet, he says that in July 1905, I did my bath on the hand of Hazrat Jariullah, the stalwart of Allah Almighty, in the garbs of kings. In those days, Masjid Mubarak was a small mosque, and 4 or 5 people could sit in one row, and the mosque used to be filled very soon. And that month was very hot in July. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, when he was sitting there, then I used to, there was a handy fan that I used to move around him. And his Mauli Muhammad Ali Sahib's office was upstairs. And Mauli Sahib had to say something to the promised Messiah. And he said that he would sit down and express his whatever he wanted. And there was no place to sit. And he just sat next to, sitting next to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, and moved the fan. And Mauli Muhammad Ali Sahib hinted to someone that I should go back. When I wanted to move back, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, he put his hand on my thigh and he said, you keep sitting here and don't move. So I continued doing my service, and Mauli Muhammad Ali Sahib, he kept standing and said whatever he had to say, and the Huzoor replied. And Maulvi Sahib, he wrote it down and he went back. In those days, this was not noted. Now I enjoy this thing, that I was a very simple, ordinary person. I even did not know Urdu properly. And Maulvi Muhammad Ali Sahib was MA, he was a scholar, but in the sight of the Prophet of Allah Almighty, the humble people and the great people, they are the same. And I continued doing that, and every day I was able to see the bright, beautiful face of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam, the blessed face. And it always occurred to me that as if he has just come out of bathroom, and from the hair there used to be some drops of water as if they are the pearls. And I didn't see any sign of any grief on his face. Whenever I looked at him, he was there was a smile on it. And Chaudhry Abdul Hakim Sahib, son of Chaudhry Sharfuddin Sahib, Bhakat Jiman district from Gujranwala, he says that in 1902, it was summer, and in Multan, Kent, I was on the railway station, and I was working there as the signal man, and my parents were from Ahle Hadith, and Maulvi Abdul Jabbar and Maulvi Abdul Ghaffar of Ahle Hadith, both were brothers, and they used to, there was a bookshop near the Multan Fort. I used to study the Holy Quran from these two people. That suddenly I met, all of a sudden I met Badruddin Ahmadi, who was the headmaster of a primary school in the village. He asked me to read Al-Hakam, and I remember that on the first page of Al-Hakam, it was written that the latest revelation from Allah and the blessed words of the Imam al-Zaman, Imam of the Age. And I used to read that, and there used to be certain such an attraction in my heart that and I wanted that I should go to the presence of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam as quickly as possible. It was the blessing of Allah Almighty, and despite the fact that the misleading of these Ahle Hadith Maulvi, within a short time I accepted Ahmadiyyat very soon. Maulvi Badruddin Sahib, he asked me to go to Qadian immediately. And another Ahle Hadith, Maulvi along with me, he is a student of Maulvi Sultan Mahmood Sahib, Ahle Hadith scholar. And he says that when we, both of us, we were very poor, I had only 15 rupees monthly pay, and I took leave, and I did not have the entitlement of a railway pass. So I purchased the ticket up to Amritsar, because we did not have enough pay to pay up to Qadian, and then our ticket finished at Amritsar. And we took the train to Batala, and we had only 8 anas in our pocket. So we purchased ticket for Veer K in 2 anas. And then he says, then we thought of going to Batala, and we don't have enough money. And the ticket checker was there, he came. But despite checking it properly, he checked it and returned to us. And when we came out of the ticket, the ticket checker checked it and didn't say anything. So we continued praying that for a pious person, a purpose we are traveling, Allah Almighty safeguarded us from all types of disgrace. And that's a very ticket enabled us to reach up to the destination. And he said that we considered that this is the very first miracle that we have seen. His intention was pious because of the difficulty, inability, he did it, but not with the intention of cheating anybody. Anyway, he says that from Batala to Qadian, we traveled on foot. We walked on foot, and when we reached in Qadian, when we entered into Masjid Mubarak, immediately Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam came in that very moment. And the friend who was with me, he was a alim from Ahle Hadith. And as soon as he met the promised Messiah, he asked a question that when Quran and Hadith, they are quite enough for our guidance, so then what is the need of doing your bath? Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam stood immediately, and he started his speech. And before the end of Huzur's speech, this person who asked the question, he said, "I am fully satisfied and I do the bath." Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam said, "Wait and be fully satisfied. Maybe that you are not deceived." So after leading the Zohar and Asr prayer, he went back into his house. At the end of the speech of the Masih Maud alayhi salam, Mawli Abdul Karim Sahib mentioned that everything has been published in the newspaper. Whatever the question he has asked, everything, the answer is there. And what is the need of doing the bath of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam? These question answer has already taken place. But anyway, he says, but the people who come from outside, they ask the question again and put trouble to the put him into trouble and don't read the newspaper. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam said that I make the speech and you feel trouble for that. What is that? Uh, And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam used to give reply to all the questioners very with a smile on his face. And Maulvi Sharfuddin Sahib's son, he relates that the evening when I did my bath, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, when he went back, then I went to Hazrat Khalifa Masih Awwal, who near the roof of the Masjid Mubarak, near in a small room there, and the previous narration is also from him. He said that there was a small cot, Indian style, was there, and I sat there on that and asked him several questions, except one thing, and I don't remember anything apart from that. And Hazrat Khalifa Awwal replied to me that the opponents, they say that Nuruddin has gone to Qadian in order to get some worldly gains, but I have got this simple cot, he was sitting on that, that I have got that cot on which my half of my body is down, and I am just here for the sake of Allah Almighty, and that I have found by doing the bath at the hands of the promised Messiah, and that God for which I have done the bath, that I have found. This was the greatest honor for which Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has mentioned in that verse which he has read, that how wonderful it would be that everybody becomes like Nuruddin. If this will be possible if the heart of everyone is filled with the faith. And the translation is, how good it would be that if in every heart there should be the passion and the feelings like Nuruddin. And this will be only at that time when every heart is completely filled with the faith regarding the claim of the promised Messiah. If they are firmly established on that faith, then that they will be able to enjoy that which was given to Hazrat Maulana Nuruddin Sahib. Hazrat Hamid Hussain Khan Sahib, who was Muhammad Hussain Sahib Muradabad's son, he says that in 1902 I came from Aligarh and got employed in Meerut, and after some time Khan Sahib Zulfikar Ali Khan Sahib, he came to Meerut, and as he was Ahmadi, and he had already done bath of the promised Messiah, so then there was this mention was being made, and Sheikh Abdul Rashid Sahib, and at his camp, and Mauli Zulfikar Ali Khan Sahib started coming to his house, and Khan Sahib, because I was a student in Aligarh, he loved me, and Khan Sahib, I started visiting his house as well, and I showed interest in looking at some books. So Khan Sahib gave me some small pamphlets and booklets in which Barakatul Dua was there, which I read, and some other books were also there. He said I started looking at those books. Wali Muhammad Hassan Sahib Amrohi, he came to Khan Sahib, and he went to Meerut for some debate, and there was only one subject of discussion, and that was the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. And Meerut, because of the wicked people of the Meerut, was not successful. But Mauli Muhammad Hassan Sahib, the speech about Mir Muhammad Hassan Sahib about Hazrat Isa's death, that I did listen, and there was a scuffle as well, dispute as well. But he says, in any way, after that he says that I had great desire to see the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. I asked Khan Sahib Mausuf that if Hazrat Aqdas, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, come near Meerut, then let me know. I would like to see that person. If I don't see him, that will be great misfortune for me. So at that time I did not have any idea of doing the bath, but in 1904 there was a great earthquake, and about which it was said that this was the according to the prophecy of the promised Messiah. And then one day Khan Sahib told me that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam is coming to Delhi, so you also come along to go and see him. I agreed, and then we went to Delhi. In Delhi, Huzur's residence was in one Haveli, Araf Khan. was there. We went to Delhi. It was about 12 or 1 o'clock. And Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam residence in the upper part of the house, he was there. And other people were staying on the ground floor. And I saw Maulvi Mohammad Hasan Sahib because I knew him because of my stay in Meerut. So I sat along with him and I started talking to him. After a while, Khan Sahib, who was sitting in the veranda, and Hazrat Taqdis was staying on the upper floor, he called me to go him. I sat on one cot on the lower side and started talking to him. And where the place where I sat, very near, there was a staircase to go upstairs. And Hazrat Taqdis Masih Maud alayhi salam, from the upper side, he came down. And I was having my back on towards the staircase. And I didn't see him coming. And Hazur alayhi salam, he came and very quietly. And he sat on the in that cot on the lower side. And very informally, he sat there very quietly. And when Hazur sat down here, then there was nobody to recognize. And somebody told me that Hazrat Sahib has arrived. I got, and I wanted to get up. But Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam took hold of me by hand and asked me that I should sit down. And after his arrival, all the people who were in the resident residing there, they came to know, and there was activity going on everywhere. And Khan Sahib mentioned to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam that this person has come from Meerut, and there were several other topics. And after a while, the Zohar and Asr prayer was offered there. And after that, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam said that those people who do want to do the bath, they should come forward. And some other person also spoke loudly, and many people came forward, and I was lagging behind. And before starting the bath, and those people who cannot reach me, they should keep their hands on the back of the first person and repeat after me the wording. And even at that time, I kept quiet there because there was no intention of bath. And I did not put my hand on the back of the person in front of me. But when the bath started, then my hand, without my intention on my part, it automatically went on to the back of that person who was sitting in front of me. And along with that, I started repeating the wording of the pledge and the bath. And then he says that I firmly remember that my hand did not move with my intention. Automatically it moved. When Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam prayed this, that, O my Allah, that I have sinned myself. And when Hazrat Masih, I also repeated, but when Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam repeated the meaning and asked the people to repeat, when I repeated those words, then remembering my sins, I was overwhelmed with emotions. And so much so that I started crying so loudly that everybody was worried. And I became unconscious in my in grief and in my crying. And Aqdas Masih Maud alayhi salam asked somebody to bring the water. He said some words of prayer, and then it was sprinkled upon me. I remember that when I was unconscious, that there were columns of different colors. They were going up into the heaven, and somebody lifted me from the heaven, from the floor. And my condition was totally changed. That when I came back to Meerut, I used to cry again and again. And then Review and Badr, they were started coming to me. And in Badr, there was the latest revelation of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam, used to be published. I got in love with that. And every time I wanted to find out what is the latest revelation coming to the. And then I started going to Jalsa, to Darul Aman Qadian. And I started writing letters for prayer to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam. And one reply was given in his own hand that I still have with me. But I had it with me, but later on I misplaced it somewhere. Mistri Allah Ditta Sahib, son of Sadruddin Sahib, from district Gurdaspur. He says that in 1894 he did the bath, and in the same year he saw the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. He says that my father was Mir Allah Ditta. I read Quran Majid, the Holy Quran, the wording, and he used to say that Imam Mahdi is about to come. When he comes, then you do the bath. And when I told him that in Qadian Imam Mahdi has come, then I asked to my teacher Mehrullah, according to his advice, I did the bath. And my brother, we came to Qadian, and we also did the bath on hand of the promised Messiah. And then we used to come for Jummah regularly, and we used to offer the Jummah along with him. Hazrat Sahib used to say that our friends, if they come to you, then you should look after them by way of hospitality. And Bhamdi Sahib used to come to us, and Mufti Fadlur Rahman Sahib used to also come to us. He says that many times I have heard the promised Messiah that our community is truthful, and it is not going to see any downfall. The truth is always remains, while the falsehood vanishes away. And in once in summer, it was 8 o'clock in the morning, and Masih Maud al-Islam said that there is some food to be given, and the cook said that there are some bread from the last evening, and Masih Maud al-Islam ate it himself. And also there were certain guests at that time who were going to go back to their homes, and he said that this stale food, if it is eaten, which is prepared some time ago, that is a part of the tradition of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And son of Mia Sharfuddin Sahib, a tailor master from Gujranwala, his son says, he writes that I did the bath of the promise in 1897, but I did not disclose it to my father for some time. But how long I could keep it secret, the secret was out. And then my father turned me away from his house, and I said that Allah Almighty is the provider, depending upon him. I took a shop on rent, but I had the desire in my heart that I should prepare some dress for the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam and present to him. So with that intention, I prepared one shirt and one other garment, and one also a turban. And I prepared everything, the full dress was prepared, and then I got the money for the travel expenses to Qadian, and then I arrived in Qadian Sharif, and next day was the Jummah. And I thought that if this very modest, humble gift, if it could be presented to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam the same day, it may be that Huzoor may wear it and use it before the Jummah and please my heart. So I was thinking, Qazi Ziauddin Sahib, when I arrived at his shop and I expressed my heartfelt desire, he said that, yes, you come along with me, I take you to the promised Messiah. And immediately he took me to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam. Hazur alayhi salam, he was sitting and writing something, and Khaja Kamaluddin Sahib, he was sitting on a mat in front of that, and we sat along with the Khaja Sahib. And Khaja Sahib asked, how have you come? Qazi Sahib expressed my desire, and Khaja Sahib kept quiet, and then he asked me that, should I plead your case? I said it will be very kind. So then Khaja Sahib took those clothes from me and presented to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, and also mentioned that this is the desire of this boy, that Huzoor may wear these and come for the Jummah in those clothes. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam immediately took the clothes and started wearing it. But it means that Huzoor might have started looking at that, and Huzoor put on the coat. It was a bit tight. I said it's a bit tight, so if you take it off, and I will loosen it and make it a bigger one. And immediately I went to the tailor's shop, and then I opened it up and made it slightly bigger, and then presented again. and then Huzur put it on, but still it was not possible to button it up proper, but he pulled it together and then I wondered whether these are worthy of his use or not. And he did not, he did not think of this thing, whether these clothes are worthy for him to use or not. Master Khalil Rahman Sahib writes, who is son of Maulvi Nek Alam Sahib from Jammu, in the Jalsa of 1907, when Hazrat Masih came for Jalsa in Masjid Aqsa, the mosque was already full and there was no place to sit. Dr. Mirza Yaqub Sahib was along with him, the promised Messiah, and in his under the arm he had the prayer mat. And then Sur said that the shoes should be removed and the prayer mat should be spread there, and the people should sit on that. And I was able to offer the prayer on the left side of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. On that day, Hazrat Masih Maud, alayhi salatu wasalam, the stalwart of Allah, after his speech was after the Jalsa, and after 5 hours his speech started. And I didn't listen to any speech of the other speakers. And I continued looking at the blessed face of Hazrat Masih Maud, alayhi salatu wasalam, and I was profusely weeping and crying. And it was in my mind that I may not be able to see his face later on in my life. So 5 hours continuously, I continued gazing at the face of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. And I do not remember anything spoken by any speaker at that time. And I continued crying, and alhamdulillah, I continued crying, and then Huzur came to the stage, and after he recited a surah, and a surah Alhamd, he gave the commentary, very beautiful and very fine, he explained that. Because of the snow, I was delayed, although I started a bit early, but now the sun has come up after the start of the Jumma. So now you can wait for a few minutes, if not the full time, but at least I will take some time more than the usual. Hazrat Ghulam Rasool Sahib, Changriya, district Tahsil Masroor, from district Sialkot, he says that this humble self, by the grace of Allah, he is from among the companions of the promised Messiah. In 1901 or 1902, I did my bath at the hand of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. At that time, I stayed there for 1 week. And whenever he used to, generally after the Maghrib prayer, he used to sit there. At that time, we used to press his legs and body. And he didn't stop us from doing so. And his face was such that those doubts which the non-Ahmadis Maulvi used to create, they were completely removed. And I had heard from those people, I had heard that the face of the promised Messiah will be shining like a star, and I found it that way. And all my questions and doubts, they were removed by looking at the face. And when the Karamdin made a claim and in the court of Lala Chandulal, and then there was everybody was thinking that the promised Messiah might be sent to jail. And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam used to say that people are saying it, this rumor, spreading the rumor. Allah Almighty says that I will give you such a victory, the victory that was given in the field of Badr. And these words are still echoing in my ears. Hazrat Rahmatullah Sahib Ahmadi, pensioner, he says that my name Rahmatullah, from district I am, district Ludhiana, who says that by the grace of Allah Almighty chose me and made me in the servitude of the promised Messiah. Otherwise, I am very humble, good for nothing. And detail is very interesting. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam stayed in Ludhiana I was only 17, 18 years old, and I was a student. In those days, I used to go to his presence occasionally, and the light which was in his face, that I saw that, and my heart used to compel me and tell me that this is not the face of a liar. But the Maulvis, they used to create the doubts, put doubts. And then there was a debate with Maulvi Muhammad Hussain, and I was present there. And after that, for my guidance, the Izalah Oham was printed for my guidance. And Allah Almighty knows that most of the time I didn't sleep at night time. And if during the reading I dozed off, that was another thing. But otherwise, I used to read and used to cry. And I used to say, "Oh Allah, why people are leaving the Holy Quran?" And Allah Almighty knows that there was the light, the flame of love was there in my heart. And I wrote to that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam establishes the wafat, the death of Hazrat Isa from 30. So all those verses which establishes life. You write down for me, and those 30 verses for the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, and you write down the negation and the reply to that, and I will get everything published. And he replied, Maulvi Muhammad Hussain, he said that don't get into any debate about the subject of the death of Hazrat Isa, because if you go to the Holy Quran, then the verses of about the death of Hazrat Isa is there. This subject is a controversial. Maulvi Sahib, Nonamdi Maulvi, wrote to him that this is a controversial subject. Don't discuss it. You discuss this subject, that how he has become Masih Maud. And he replied that if Hazrat Isa alayhi salam had died, then he is a truthful person. And he said that perhaps you are influenced by the promised Messiah. And then in reply, I said that he said, "You pray for yourself." He said, "I will do, but you also pray for yourself." And later on, I prayed to Allah Almighty, and I very fervently I prayed, and I moved the Allah's throne, and I said I need the guidance, and I sacrifice every honor for your sake, and I'm ready to accept every disgrace. You have mercy upon me. And after some time, and I swear in the name of that being in whose hand is my life, I swear in his name that in the morning at 4 o'clock in the morning on 25 December, then I was able to see the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in my dream. And detail of that is that I was performing a wuzu before the prayer. Somebody said that Rasul Arabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam has come, and he is now going to stay here in this country. He said, "Where?" And he said, "These tents are of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." I immediately went there, and Hazur was there among some companions. After salam, I had the honor of shaking hand with him, and I sat with him, and Hazur was talking in Arabic. I understood to some extent according to my ability, and then he used to speak Urdu, and he said, "I am truthful person, don't deny me," etc. He says that I immediately said that I believe and I acknowledge your truth, O Prophet of Allah. The whole village was of Muslims. That this is the day when all the Muslims should have been coming here, but I was told that Huzur is now going to stay in this country. But Huzur decided to travel, and I said, "Huzur, now you are going out, how can I meet you?" He put his hand on my shoulder and he said, "The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam," he said, "don't worry, we will come and see you." And I understood the message, that the message of Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam is from him. And I immediately wrote a letter of bath to the promised Messiah alaihi salatu wasalam. And then I had the honor of doing my bath after the Maghrib. And by the grace of Allah Almighty, gave me that a certainty of faith, that nobody can shake my faith and nobody can create any doubt into my mind. So this is all because of the blessing of the company of the promised Messiah, which I got frequently. And these hands have the honor of pressing the body of the promised Messiah. Although I had many difficulties later on, but Allah Almighty protected me from all that, and safeguarded from all the losses, and blessed me more than that. And my brothers and my father, they all, by the grace of Allah, they accepted Ahmadiyyat and became Ahmadi. Hazrat Maulvi Fateh Ali Sahib, Ahmadi Munshi Fazal Dulmial District Jhelum, he says that in 1904, along with my family, I did the bath at the hand of the promised Messiah, and during his lifetime, every year, along with my family, I used to come and visit him regularly. And whenever Huzur used to come out for the prayer and the community from Dulmial, they used to sit along with him. And we used to get benefit from his wording. And sometime we requested for prayers. That was a small mosque. Only four or five people could stand in one line. Then the mosque was extended. And once the Imam Masjid for community, Mauli Karamdad Sahib, he requested that there is an Imam in the mosque, Sayyid Jafar Shah, he is your follower, but he believes in you, but occasionally he joins the prayer of the funeral prayer along with the non-Ahmadis. Sometime he offered the prayers behind non-Ahmadis. And I said that he is so much devoted that once he asked me to write a letter and dictated that I am a servant of the dogs of the promised Messiah. And if there is any deficiency on our part, then please forgive that. As Masih Maud al-Islam said, that until up to this time, if because of the greed of the world, he continues to offer the prayer behind other people, and those people who deny the promised Messiah, he is offering the prayer behind them, then how can he be counted among our followers? Don't offer the prayer behind him. And then he got the sewing machine, and Mirza Sharif Ahmad Sahib was 7-8 years old at that time, and I was preparing a coat. And then I prepared that, and he used to come from Kyuda, from Dulmial, and the lady said that we have to travel for 10-11 miles, so we can't bring our beddings. Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam asked Hazrat Sheikh Ahmad Ali Sahib, who was the one of the disciple, that you give beddings to the people from Dulmial. He says that the endurance and the of the promised Messiah, that we used to ask for certain medicines from the promised Messiah. Once my son Abdul Aziz, late, he was only 7-8 years, he came along with that, and he used to recite the verses of the Durrasmeen in a very melodious voice in the meetings, and also he used to go inside the house and recite, and Huzur loved him very much, and the request from people from Dulmial he used to convey. Once a person wrote a request for a special purpose and gave to Abdul Aziz to give it to inside and get the permission to go to house. Huzur was lying in the bed after the Fajr prayer, and this boy was a very small boy, and he didn't know the proper way, and he went inside and he removed the kilt from the face and gave that letter and requested for the person to come in. And he said, my parents may be sacrificed, but instead of saying scolding him, he just very loving and kind way, he did not say anything, and this is what actually won the heart of all the people for the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. Hazrat Bahawal Shah Sahib, son of Sher Muhammad Sahib from Ambala, he writes that this humble self enabled Allah Almighty enabled the promise to see meet the promised Messiah, and what blessings I got, there are quite details. I say in the name of absolutely one God, and in whose name the telling lie is an accursed thing. And I had great love since my childhood, and following because of and there was a court litigation for 3 years, and there was and the people in, because the people they were responsible for that, they actually felt the pain of that, and they had the desire of a person who could guide him. And there were several other people, but no one gave the satisfaction. And according through one person who was my teacher, and who was Mawli Abdul Haq Sahib, who was living at that time. He was the father of that, who is living at this time, but he was not he was not among the believers of the promised Messiah, the father of Abdul Haq, and who became Ahmadi after my becoming Ahmadi, and then he died. The son did not accept Ahmadiyyat, but the father accepted. Regarding him, he says that Allah Almighty have mercy on him. Regarding the claims of the promised Messiah, when he used to listen and he used to say that the time requires an imam of the age, and Mirza Sahib is true imam, so then why people are speaking ill about him? And he used to see referring to us that you never say anything ill about him, bad about him. And when there was Mawli Nazir Hussain Sahib in Delhi, there was a verdict against him. At that time, Mawli Abdul Haq Sahib and myself, they were students with Mawli Nazir Hussain Sahib to get the education. After 6 months, I came back. But Mawli Abdul Haq Sahib, he continued to study in Delhi. Mawli Muhammad Hussain, when he came back from Delhi, then in order to spread the disbelief of the promised Messiah, he did his effort. He says that you have already spoken a lot of ill about him. What else I can do? And finally, Muhammad Hussain got disappointed from there, and he went back. He actually wanted other people to also come and endorse his view. Mawli Abdullah Snorri Sahib, who was a very devout companion of the promised Messiah, and Masih Maud has mentioned about him, he was in great love. When the litigation continued, became very long, then Mawli Abdullah Snorri Sahib, then he was sent to request prayers for that. And then Huzoor started asking about this. And everybody was saying that people should not go there. People are saying ill against the promised Messiah, and you will become like that, so therefore don't go there. And I would say that if he is true, then I am not afraid of any Maulvis. And in 1998, I reached Qadian. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam was sitting on the rooftop of the mosque. Mawli Abdul Karim Sahib, Razillah Ta'ala Anho, Mufti Muhammad Sadiq Sahib, Razillah Ta'ala Anho, and some other companions, they were also sitting with him. Mawli Abdul Qadir Sahib of Ludhianvi, he was also standing on the stairs. And he was the teacher, and he also knew me, so he met me warmly, and he was very happy to see me, and he asked me that, have you come to do the bath? He said, I have just come to request the prayers. And then he said that, are you afraid of the Maulvis? I said, I am not afraid of Maulvis, but the truth of him is clear from his face. This face cannot be the face of a liar. And that was very close to the sunset. And another person who had come for bath for many days, he said, take my bath because I have to go home. He said, you stay here and you should get full satisfaction. And then he got busy in other things. And Mawli Abdul Qadir Sahib mentioned about me that this person wants to do the bath. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, who was sitting somewhere, he immediately came to the floor and he said, the person who has to do the bath, he should come forward. And that person was right near the promised Messiah. So I started from the stairs to the promised Messiah, and then I was away, slightly away. And then there was so much attraction on my heart, as if somebody is pulling me towards him. And I cried vehemently, and helplessly I sat there, and very happily I extended my hand to the promised Messiah, and both of us, we did the bath. And after that, we requested a prayer for the court litigation, and Huzoor prayed. And I stayed there for 10 days after that. He says that with Huzoor and with Qadian, I got so much law. I didn't like to go back. Qadian was like Bahisht for paradise, where except from Allah, the mention of Allah Almighty, the worldly mention was nowhere there. from everywhere, salaman salama, peace and peace. That was the only voice we used to listen. And that was the time when there was a wrong allegation, a murder case was going on or it had finished. That was the time he is referring to. He said that later on I took permission and came back. And then he says that after doing my bath, after doing the bath, my condition changed altogether. There was so much love of Allah Almighty that through the night and the day, except from the remembrance of Allah, I didn't like even to go to sleep. And whenever I used to sleep, I used to get up suddenly as if somebody has been taken away from the beloved one. And there was a strange condition of my heart. It appeared as if somebody has cleansed my heart, washed my hands, and there was a dedication and devotion. That was the result of the attention of the promised Messiah. And one day I felt as if the heart has been cut and it has been washed and a new spirit has been put into that one, which is called the Holy Spirit. And my condition was like the pregnant woman, and I felt as if I'm carrying a child. And my person was illuminated, very purified, and there was so much taste in my tongue. And the people who were offering prayer behind me, they used to also enjoy. And they used to say that, what a wonderful prayer you have led. This was not actually my condition. Actually, it was the reflection of the condition of the promised Messiah. And the case, by the grace of Allah Almighty, immediately we won that. But Allah Almighty, this was the cause which made me to go to the promised Messiah. And this humble servant had the visit of the heavens and also enabled him to see the promised Messiah. And I used to take the books of the promised Messiah and the books of the opponents, and very carefully I used to read all of them. The arguments of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam, they were supported by the verses of the Holy Quran. When I was looking at the book of an opponent, I was surprised that what sort of scholars these people are who are writing such books. I was overtaken by sleep and I had the revelation, bal ajabu an jaahum qaumun munzirun. And this verse affected my heart so much, as if something comes directly into the heart. And it came to the heart, and immediately I spoke with my tongue. And I came to know that these are the people that when the warning party, that is the prophets, when they came, then I used to write my revelations to the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam, occasionally. He says, when there was any allegation or objection against the promised Messiah, then immediately some verse of the Holy Quran would come in front of me, and with that I used to reply. Once a Maulvi came and he said that the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, show me from the where the word maut is mentioned there, the death. And he said, وَإِمِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لَيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ. So then from among the people of the book, no one after reading this one, he will not, that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam has died his natural death, not his death on the cross. And they would believe on this one, they would believe in this thing that he did not die. And this word Bihi is referring to that one. And a natural death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is being mentioned. And Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will give the witness that I did not die on the cross, but according to the verdict of the Holy Quran, I have died a natural death. And Maulvi, after listening to this one, he immediately ran away. And the majority of the people in that village, they became Ahmadi, but after the intimidation of the Maulvi, some of the people, they went back. Hazrat Madad Khan Sahib, رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, who who was Inspector Baitul Mar in Qadian from Kashmir. He was from Kashmir. In 1896 he did the Baith, and in 1904 he was able to see the Promised Messiah come and see him. He says that, O my beloved Allah, that I am going to write about your beloved Prophet, enable me to write truly and truthfully. Once in 1904, when there was a case against Karamdin and in the court of Chandulal, and Khwaja Kamaluddin Sahib was the pleader, and Mol Raj and others, they were on the from the other side. Ahmad Noor Sahib and Ahmad Ali Sahib, they brought the books from Qadian. They say that Muhammad Ismail Sahib, he was very upset. So I asked why he is so much upset. He said, I am worried because I have heard that people have thought and that Masih Maud al-Islam should be jailed only for a short time. Chandulal has determined that, and I have been informed by a high official. I asked Dr. Sahib, what do you want that? What should be done? He said that somebody should do something, give this message to Hazrat Masih Maud that he should not come into Gurdaspur. He should get the certificate for his sickness, and even if you have to spend 100 rupees, then you do it, but don't come. But I said, does it mean that it should be a false certificate? But he said that if somebody has to get the reward, then sawab, then he has to do it. And he said that give me the lantern and I will go back the same night. And he gave me the lantern. From Gurdaspur, I started walking towards Qadian. And in the way, there were two people, Hamid Ali Sahib and Munshi Abdul Ghani Sahib. I met them. And at 2 o'clock, we reached the masjid in Qadian. Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam came out when he came to know about us. And we said, Assalamu alaikum. Then he came out. And he said that you had gone to with the books to the Gurdaspur. I told him the whole story, that Dr. Ismail Sahib is very much upset and he has given this message. Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam said, this giddiness, that is a problem I have. And I had the idea that I may not be able to go, but now I am not going to stay here. I will go to Gurdaspur and I am not worried about anything. And I was a bit tired, that's why I went to sleep. He slept there. Masih Maud al-Islam went to Gurdaspur. It's a long story, he says, that people stopped me that I should not be going there, but Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam has already left. He might have already reached there, but when I got up, he says that I again started on foot, and when Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam had said that I should not come on foot, but rather he should go by horse-driven carriage, he said, on the way I felt very bad. I had some fever. People asked, stop me from going because this is your third trip. You must be very tired. But and you are not accustomed to this walking. But he said, but anyway, I reached there. And in the house, I reached there. It was evening, and that was the place where Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam was residing. When I entered there, I heard that, have you brought Madad Khan on the in carriage or not? When I went into the open area, then Hazur, people told them that Madad Khan is there, and I also said the salam. Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam extended his hand and took hold of my hand and said, Jazakallah, well done, and this is very full of courage. This is the third trip of this person. Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam, he took hold of my hand. I felt it appeared to me as if I have never went to Qadian from Gurdaspur. While my condition was there that I didn't like to speak to anyone, I was feeling some temperature. But the divinely sign was there that Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam did not leave my hand until I felt that I am completely relieved and there is no sign of tiredness. And previously I was like a dead person. And after that I felt completely relaxed. And I feel quite all right. And there was no ailment left there. So what is this? This is a miracle of the promised Messiah. I thought that I believe that the hunger and thirst, sometime through the happiness, these things go away. But this, you know, the extreme need of sleeping and hunger, how these tiredness, how these things can be removed. Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam did not leave my heart until all my ailments they had gone. Previously, my heart, body was like a stone, and it was difficult to move. This is like bringing back a dead person. And before that, I had never gone to Gurdaspur. Huzur asked that the food should be brought. Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam asked me to sit along with him, and I had the food. And this was the special hospitality and kindness of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. And I used to, I wish that Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam should take utter my name and call me by name. And Huzur, during this time, he used to call me by name and utter my name many times. So these are some of the narrations of these saintly people which I have related many times before, and I repeat it many times. And particularly those families to whom these saintly people belong to, or they belong to those saintly people. How much favor is there of these saintly people upon us? Otherwise, many people today, they may not have that courage to accept the truth as these saintly people have accepted that. So therefore, the progenies, they must pray for these saintly people of their ancestor. And also along with that, for the faith and the strength of their own faith, they should continuously pray. And they should also try to follow in their footsteps, in their example, they should also follow. And the relationship that they had with the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam, keeping that in view, they should try to follow in their footsteps and follow their example. And these people were such that some of them, because of the their modest knowledge, but in order to have satiate their spiritual desire, they had their desire, and they actually satiated themselves in that way. And similarly, they had developed their relationship with Allah Almighty as well. There are some examples of that. So these are the examples of the devotion and fidelity which their people of their progeny, they should remember it. May Allah enable us, all of us, that we should continue to follow these examples of devotion and dedication, and take care of that.
Alhamdulillah nahmadu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد ان لا اله الا الله ونشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل واللسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر